Thank you. Welcome, everybody. Welcome to you at home to another edition of Card Sharks. We've got some contestants for you to meet, and one of them hopes to drive out of here in that brand-new Pontiac Firebird. Don't forget about the money cards. Let's get started right now by meeting our lovely dealers. They are backstage. Come on out, ladies. Here comes Susanna Williams and Lacey Pemberton.
Hello.
Hello. We haven't given away a car in a few days.
Oh, I'm ready.
Are you ready, to do
yes.
it?
Yes.
Why don't we go out and pick it up from where we left off yesterday? We're in the middle of a first game right now. Let's meet our card sharks. Here they come. Hello, Patrice.
Hello.
Patrice is our returning champion. And you're a substitute teacher, am I right?
Yes, I am. I work every Friday in a third grade class.
Ah.
So it's a permanent situation, but it's substituting.
Did you go into substitute teaching because you had to give it up when you had the family of
exactly,
your own?
Exactly, because I have three boys.
And then you got three boys?
Yes.
Well, so do I. What are their ages?
3, 6, and 8.
3, 6, and 8.
Yes.
Yeah, they're right. Oh, they're movers, too. Yes. Movers and shakers. A lot of carpooling going on.
Yes.
She is our champion. Patrice now has $11,375. Yeah. Hello, Terry.
Hi, Bill. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you, sir. Introduce yourself, please.
My name is Terry Keyes. I live in the San Francisco Bay Area, where I'm an investment planner.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, in Los Gatos, am I correct?
Exactly.
Down there. That's right. That's Santa Cruz, down by the boardwalk. Real pretty country. Okay, we are in the middle of our first game right now, coming up on our third question, and Lacey's already dealt out the cards. Let's get to it right now. Just a quick reminder, though, don't forget about our prize cards. We have a trip to London, England in there. And we've got a refrigerator, freezer, a lot of stuff going on. Here is our first question for Patrice, third question, rather. And it is our audience poll. We have 10 young ladies over the age of 65. They're with us this week. Welcome to you, ladies. Patrice, before the show, we asked these 10 senior citizen women, is it okay to live with a man before you marry him? How many of these 10 women said it is okay to live with a man before you marry him?
I think these ladies come from the old school where it wasn't okay before. They're probably becoming more liberal in their thinking, but I don't think it's all of them, that's for sure. I think five of them say it's okay.
Five, right in the middle, right in the fence. Terry, what do you think, higher or lower?
I think they come from the old school, but maybe they believe about the new school. I'm going to say a little bit higher.
You're going a little higher?
A little higher than that.
A little higher. Depending on how long some of them have been married, they may say it's not really a good idea after you're married either, but anyway. The actual number of these women who said it is okay to live with a man before you marry him is 6. It is a little higher. It is a little higher. All right, ladies, thank you very much. Let's go on over here right now. And, Terry, you can change this card.
I'm going to change that card, please, though.
All right. That 8 now becomes a 4.
Woo. Okay, I got to go higher. I got to go higher.
Higher than a 4 for game number 1. It is.
Woo.
Yeah. Tough. Okay. Very good, Terry. You've got one game on your side of the board. The player who wins 2 games, they win the match. They go to the money cards. And, of course, that brand-new car, that brand-new Pontiac Firebird is awaiting for somebody, we hope. And but this is a familiar scenario to Patrice. She was down 1 game before and came back to do it. She has her work cut out for her now. And Lacey's already dealt out the cards for game number 2. And let's get started. Terry, first question is for you. Educated guess.
Okay.
Ah, how many miles was Paul Revere's ride? Again, let me remind our bachelors at home, these are great starting conversations when you're out there looking. Don't forget about the termites yesterday. And, of course, Paul Revere's ride, definite score possibility on this one. So, Terry.
Well, I'm from back east, and my company's from Boston, so I should probably know the answer to this question, but I have no idea. I'm gonna say about 24 miles.
24 miles. Patrice, what do you think?
I think on horseback they couldn't cover as much area in as fast a time as we could today, but I still think it's higher. I'm going to go higher.
You're going higher than 24? Yeah. I have no idea. I'm with Terry. I don't know. The actual length in miles of Paul Revere's... Can we get a host that speaks English on this show? The actual length in miles of Paul Revere's ride was 17. It was not higher.
Woo.
Beautiful. 17. Interesting number. Terry, you're going to the base card here. Tell me what you want to do. You got a 3.
Okay, I'll keep that card and 1 higher.
You're
come on,
go higher.
Higher
than a 3, Woo. A queen.
I'm going to go lower.
Lower than a queen, we've got a 10.
Woo. I'm going to go lower than a 10.
He's going to go lower than a 10. He's got a 5.
Woo. I'm going to go higher. Last time. Let's go.
This could be it. The game, the match. Higher than a 5. Get it.
Yeah.
Woo.
Great.
4 for 3. Well, not 2-4.
Yeah,
not
job.
2-4.
You were there. You had to sit and watch that one go right by you again.
Oh,
that's the way the game is played. You have $11,375.
That's fantastic.
And I think a mom of three would know what to do with that
definitely,
money.
Definitely.
Thank you so much. We're going to see
thank
you, Patrice. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Come on, Terry. Well, congratulations, Terry.
When we come back after this commercial message, Terry's going to go to the money car. We've got a brand new car waiting. Let's see what happens. Stick around. We'll be right back.
New champ here named Terry. Terry wants to go to the money cards. He knows how to play the money cards. Suzanne and Lacey are dealing them out right now. But in addition to all the money he could win, and if you pay attention, you know that you can turn those money cards into $32,000 if you play it right. We have added a joker to the deck. And any time it turns up in the money cards, he will have an opportunity at winning this brand new car, which is a Pontiac Firebird. And for winning the match, we're going to give him an extra joker to get him started. We're going to guarantee him a chance at the car. And there's Lacey holding it for him up now. And let's get started right now. Terry, here's $200.
Okay.
Here's your base card, Terry. Here it is. You got a 2. Ooh.
Take it all higher. I want to bet it all higher.
All of it. Higher than a 2. Here's a 4. Woo! 400 on a 4.
I got 400. I'll take 350 higher.
350 higher than a 4. It is.
Woo!
750 on a 10.
Okay. I'm going to change that card, I think. I'm going to change that one even. That was number 1.
Number 1? Okay. Thank you, Susanna. That 10 now becomes an 8.
Ooh,
right
hurt,
in the middle.
Hurts,
think about this bet.
Okay.
750 on an 8.
$50 higher.
Gonna play conservative on a medium card here. $50 higher than an 8. It is a 6. Smart bet. Now, you got $700. We're bringing you up to this level, Terry. We're going to give you $400 more. You now have $1,100. You're playing off a 6.
Okay, I'm going to change that card.
Tell me which one you want.
I'm going to change that with number 3.
Number 3. All right, get a good card up here. A 5. $1,100 on a 5.
Okay, 250 higher.
250 higher than a 5. Be there. It is. 1350 on a 7.
350 higher.
350 higher than a 7. Tough call on this.
Big one here somewhere.
It is a duke.
Woo! Okay.
1,000 on a duke.
Beautiful. All of it higher.
All of it. All of it higher than a 2. He's got it.
Yeah.
$2,000. Got $2,000. You're playing off a 9.
Change a 9.
Okay. You know that you must wager at least $1,000 on this card. It is a
woo!
King. You got a choice now.
$1,600 lower.
$1,600. Wants a little change to go get out of the studio with today. $1,600 lower than a king. It is.
Woo!
Good work. Good work. You had a couple of tough calls there, but you made some money on it. You made not a bad amount of money either. You made $3,600. That's
right.
Not too bad at all.
And
listen, you got that right. When we come back, sharp stick and all, he's got a joker. We've got the cards about that brand new Pontiac. We'll be right back. We're commending Terry on the yeoman's work he did on the money cards. $3,600 in his pocket right now. Plus, he has a joker. Here it is right now. Lacey's going to give it to you. This means that you're going to get a chance to win this brand new car. Gene, tell them about it.
A new Pontiac Firebird, the car that's ready to prove its Pontiac performance title whenever you are. The legendary Firebird, only from Pontiac. We build excitement worth over $14,000.
Nice, nice. That is nice. Come on up here, Terry. You're a bachelor. You'd look good in that car, wouldn't you?
Oh, sure.
I thought he would. Okay. Now, here's how you're going to do it. You got a joker. In front of you are 7 numbered cards. Behind one of them is the word car. You find it, you're going to be a happy young man. Go ahead and find it for me. Whoop. He's going with number 4. The word car is here. He's going to be a very happy guy down there in Los Gatos. No. No, no, it is not there. However, you were quite close. It is over here.
Ooh.
It is right over there, number 6. Number 6 had the word
for. Next time.
Anyway, listen, that's right. If you win our next match, you could be back here right away. And who knows what you'll do with the money cards and the car. We're back over there. It's time for you to meet your challenger now, Terry. Come on out, Virginia.
Hey, Virginia, how you doing?
Hi.
Good luck.
Here she is. Hello, Virginia.
Hello.
Introduce yourself, please.
I'm Virginia Bailey. I'm from Sunnyvale up in Northern California.
Oh, both you guys.
I've been married 51 years to the same man. We have a son and daughter and 5 grandchildren.
Good for you. Well, welcome to you. You've already cut your cards backstage?
Yes, I have.
All right. Let me just tell my contestants right now that we've added some new prize cards to the deck. A trip to the Bahamas. I love that. Oh, grandfather clock. Lots of goodies in there. Let's get going right now with our first game. Question number one. Lacey's dealing out the cards, and this one goes to Terry. Terry, you ready, sir?
Sure am.
We surveyed 100 single women, and we asked them, when away on vacation, have you ever had a romance with a guy you never considered good enough to date at home? Since none of my friends are around, you'll do. Come on over here. How many single women admitted they have settled for a romance with a guy they would never consider at home?
Okay. I'm single, and I've been on a lot of vacations with friends and that type of thing. No one's ever done that with me, but I'm sure that's happened to my friends. I've seen it happen to my friends before. So I'm going to say that's going to be a medium number, about 38.
38?
Yes.
38. What do you think, Virginia, higher or lower?
Well, I think maybe on a cruise you might be tempted to do this when romance sort of takes over, but I think maybe it would be a little lower.
A little bit lower.
Right.
The actual number of single women who have had a romance with a guy they wouldn't consider good enough at home is... 14, it is lower.
Yay!
So, Virginia goes to the cards right now. You're a single young lady.
I knew this was coming.
Have you ever dragged something home you weren't very proud of?
Oh, no, I haven't.
Okay, just checking. Here's your base card, Virginia. Oh. Tell me what you want to do. Here's a king.
Oh, good. Lower.
Going lower than a king. She's got a jack.
Oh, lower.
Lower than a jack. She's got a two.
Higher.
Higher than a two. It's an eight.
Three.
Whoa. Three. Why did I know that was coming? Don't look at me that way. I'm just curious, Lacey. Let's go on to our next question. This is for Virginia. She gets this right, she can change that eight and put some heat on the champ.
Right.
We surveyed 100 actors and actresses who appear in daytime soap operas, and we asked them, have you ever received a marriage proposal from a fan? How many soap opera stars have received a marriage proposal from a fan?
I think so many people watch soap operas these days that I'm quite sure it would be a high number. They get really emotionally involved with these actors and actresses. So I would say, maybe 65.
65. Right. Kelly, higher or lower?
Well, I don't know. I really haven't. I'm going to say it's maybe a little bit lower than that, just a little bit.
A little bit lower than 65? I'm going to go a lot lower. That's my idea. The actual number of soap opera stars who have received a marriage proposal from a fan is 63. It is lower, but by two. Just a little bit. You were right. Here we go, Tara. Here's your card. Got a queen.
I'll keep that and go lower.
He goes lower than a queen. He's got an eight.
Oh.
Wow. Just two to find that could cause you trouble, and you found one of them. All right. Now, Virginia, you know you get a free shot at it from this eight.
Right. Lower.
She's going lower than an eight. If she's right, she wins game number one. It is not.
Oh.
So, the cards are not happening. Gee, bad cards, Lacey. Your fault. Okay. Let's go on to our next question. This is the fun time again. I always love to see these ladies. We have 10 women visiting with us who are over the age of 65. And there they are. What a nice looking group. Terry, this question is for you. Before the show, we asked these 10 senior citizen women, have you ever had a full-time salaried job? How many of these 10 women have had a full-time job?
Okay, full-time's a key word here, I think.
Full-time, yes.
Full-time. I'm going to say a full-time job at some time or other, just for a short period, maybe full-time. I'm going to say it's going to be a pretty high number, probably about, I'm going to say eight.
You're going to go with eight?
I'm going to go with eight.
The actual number... I'm sorry, Virginia, what do you... That's right, I was going on with it when I shouldn't have. Anyway, Virginia, what do you think?
I think quite a few of them have, but I'm going to say lower.
You're going to go lower than eight.
Right.
I'm going to go lower than eight. I'm going to agree with Terry. The actual number of these women who have had a full-time job is nine. It is nine. So, that is interesting. All these ladies have gone out there into the workforce. Which is the young lady who's led the good life? Which one of you has not had the job? There you are, Marion. Have you been happy at home?
Well, I haven't been home that much. I've had part-time jobs.
You had part-time jobs. So that's the qualifier. We said full-time, and that was the qualifier. So that was it. All right, thank you very much, ladies. Let's go to the board right now. Here you are, Terry.
Okay, Bill, we're going to try lower again.
Lower.
One.
There we go.
I'm going to try and go lower again.
He goes lower than a nine. He's got a seven.
I'm going to go going to freeze the card right there with one question.
You're going to freeze on that seven.
I'm going to freeze it right there.
Yeah, he's just paying attention. He's paying attention. He knows that he's got one question left, which means when we come back after this commercial, we will face sudden death. We'll be right back. This is our fourth and final question, which means that it is sudden death. And that means that somebody must die on this next play of the card. So, good job. Just a bad joke. No, this is real important. Control of the board here is the entire key issue. And this question goes to Virginia. Virginia, educated guess. Think about it now. How many years has it been since the miniskirt was first introduced? Ooh, say the men. Ooh.
Oh, well, let me think. I would say maybe about 20 years.
20 years?
20 years.
Terry, what do you think?
Years. That would be 1966. I think it was a little bit before that. I'm going to say it's a little bit higher than that.
A little bit higher than 20?
Yeah, early 60s, I think.
I'm going out on a limb here. 28, I'm saying. The actual number of years since the miniskirt was introduced is 22. Woo. It is a little bit higher. Really? It is a little bit higher. All right, Terry, you know what you have to do.
I know my decision.
Neither one, you can change this and play on. If you make a mistake, that means that Virginia wins, or she's only got one card to turn, but she's going to be playing off an eight. Play or pass, sir?
Six of one, half a dozen of the other, I think. I'm going to change the seven and play on.
He's going to change it and play on. Okay. Tough call. That was a tough call. That seven now becomes an eight.
Okay, I'm going to say that next card is higher, Bill. Hope for a higher one.
Sudden death. Every turn of the card here means the game. Higher than an eight is the call. It is an eight, and that means that Virginia is our winner.
Oh!
You were in the rock and the hard place.
Yeah.
You really had a tough. That was a tough call all the way down the line.
I thought I'd get a good flip.
Yeah, well, Virginia, congratulations to you.
Thank you.
You won game number one. First player to win two games, they win the match. Don't forget, money cards in the car are all available. It's Lacey's going to be dealing out the cards now for game number two. This is a must-win situation for Terry if he wants to stay in this. Otherwise, Terry goes to the land of parting gifts. Terry, we surveyed 100 psychiatrists and we asked them, generally speaking, do happy people live longer? How many psychiatrists said happy people do live longer?
Okay. Bill, I think if you asked a medical person this question, they would say it makes no difference. But I think a psychiatrist might say that it has something to do with it as far as attitude. So I'm going to say 44 psychiatrists polled would say this.
44. Virginia?
Well, I think happiness plays such a great part in your life. I think they would go a little higher.
You're going higher than 44.
I'm going higher, right.
The actual number of psychiatrists who said happy people do live longer is 37. It isn't higher, it's lower. I don't know if I go to a psychiatrist. What are they doing? Anyway, all right, Terry. Take a look at your base card right now. Tell me what you want to do.
Here.
Ooh,
beautiful. All right, let's go lower on that one.
Lower than an ace. We got a king.
Beautiful. A little lower now.
Lower than a king, you got a three.
Okay, now higher.
It's happening. Higher than a three, a ten.
I'm going to go lower. Let's try it lower.
We're
going
to go for it to tie it up. Lower than a ten. Yes.
Yeah. All
right. You did it. You did it. You had to do it. Very good job, Terry. You tied up the match. When we come back after this commercial message, tiebreaker is awaiting. We'll be right back. Terry, you did it. You've done it. You've tied up the match. You were a little nervous. I thought you were going to freeze on the 10. Did you think about that?
I thought a long time about it, yeah.
But you had to go for it. Both you guys from the same area in California.
Yes,
both
in
Northern California.
Northern California.
At least, who knows what happens. Maybe you guys, after all this is over, you can call one another and go out and have cocktails. Here is Lacey and Susanna. We're going to pick it up tomorrow, right from where we left off. Tiebreaker time tomorrow, and we will see you then. Gene Woods over there. I'm Bill Rafferty. Bye-bye. We'll see you tomorrow.